like tax breaks for billionaires because we've driven up the national debt. That is just plain wrong. And Mr. President, I think the vast majority of the American people, whether they're progressives like myself or whether they're conservatives, I think they perceive that that concept, the green tax breaks, the billionaires, when we have such a high national debt, makes no sense at all. Furthermore, Mr. President, it is important to point out that extending income tax breaks to the top 2% is not the only unfair tax proposal in this agreement. This agreement between the President and the Republican leadership also calls for a continuation of the Bush-era 15% tax rate on capital gains and dividends, meaning that those people who make their living off their investments will continue to pay a substantially lower tax rate than firemen, teachers, nurses, carpenters, and virtually all the other working people of this country. And I just don't think that that's fair. That's wrong. And we are continuing, if this agreement were to be passed, that unfair arrangement. Mr. President, on top of all of that, this agreement includes a horrendous proposal regarding the estate tax. And that is a Teddy Roosevelt initiative. Now, Teddy Roosevelt was talking about this in the early years of the 20th century. It was enacted in 1916. And it was enacted for a couple of reasons. Teddy Roosevelt and the people of that era thought it was wrong that a handful of people could have a huge concentration of wealth and then just give that wealth, transmit that wealth to their children. He didn't think that that was right. Furthermore, it was a source, a progressive and fair source of revenue. Under the agreement struck between the Republican leadership and the president, the estate tax rate, which was 55% under President Clinton, and let's all remember, we had problems with the economy under President Clinton, but very few will deny that during those years, we were creating a heck of a lot more jobs than we did under President Bush. That's the fact. Over 20 million jobs under President Clinton. We lost 600,000 private sector jobs under President Bush. During the Clinton era, the tax rate on the estate tax was 55%. What this arrangement would do is lower that tax rate to 35% with an exemption on the first $5 million of an individual's estate, $10 million for couples. Now, here's the important point, Mr. President, that I think many people don't know, because I have to confess, my Republican friends and their pollsters and their language people have done a very good job. This is the so-called death tax. And I think all over America, people are saying, oh, this is terrible. I have $50,000 in the bank and I want to leave that to my kids. And the government is going to take 55% of that, 35% of that. What an outrage. So let us be very, very clear. This tax applies only to the top 0.3% of American families. 99.7% of American families will not pay one nickel in an estate tax. This is not a tax on the rich. This is a tax on the very, very, very rich. And if my Republican friends had been successful in doing what they want to do, which is eliminating this estate tax completely, it would have cost, Mr. President, our Treasury, raised the national debt by $1 trillion over a 10-year period. Families like the Walton family of Walmart fame would have received, as one family, about a $30 billion tax break. So I find it hard to believe that when we are talking about massive cuts in programs for working families, when we have this huge national debt, that anybody would be agreeing to lower the estate tax rate to 35%. That is what this agreement does, and I think that that is a very, very bad idea. And once again, while the agreement on the estate tax is for 2 years, Once again, there is very little doubt in my mind that the Republicans will continue to push for lower and lower estate tax rates because what they want, and I think Senator Kyle has been pretty clear about this, they want to permanently repeal that tax. That is $1 trillion in tax breaks to the top 0.3%. So I think we're down a bad path there, and that's another reason why this agreement does not make a whole lot of sense. Mr. President, I would say thirdly, and here's a very important point that I think has not yet gotten the attention that it deserves, and that is this agreement contains a payroll tax holiday, which would cut $120 billion from Social Security payroll taxes for workers. And I think there are a lot of folks out there who say, well, this is pretty good. You know, I'm a worker. My contribution will go from 6.2% today down to 4.2%. I'll have more money in my paycheck. It's a good idea. Let's take a deep breath and let's think about it for a second. Let's understand what this whole thing is about. This payroll tax holiday concept, as I understand it, originally started with conservative Republicans. I know the vice president recently made the point this was originally a Republican idea. Now, why did the Republicans come up with this idea? Well, these are exactly the same people who don't believe in Social Security. These are the same people who either want to make significant cuts in Social Security or else they want to privatize Social Security entirely. And here's the point. They understand that if we divert funding that is supposed to go into the Social Security Trust Fund, which is what this payroll tax holiday does, this is money that goes into the Social Security Trust Fund, is now being diverted, cut back, in order to provide financial support for workers. But that is a lot of money not going into the trust fund. Now, what the president and others are saying, well, not to worry, because that money will be covered by the general fund. That is a very, very bad and dangerous precedent, because up until now, what Social Security has been about is 100% funding from payroll contributions, not from the general tax base. Now, once again, this is a one-year program. The loss of revenue going into Social Security can be covered by the general fund. But we have a $13 trillion national debt. How much longer will the general fund put money into Social Security? Is it a good idea for the general fund to be doing that? So I would argue, Mr. President, that this is not a good idea. This is a very dangerous step forward for those of us who believe in Social Security. But this is not just Bernie Sanders saying this. Mr. President, one of the more effective and I think important senior groups in America is called the National Committee to Preserve Social Security and Medicare. They have, I don't know exactly how many, but they have many, many members all over this country. I know they're active in the state of Vermont. And I want to read to you from a press release that they just sent out the other day. And this is the headline on it, from the National Committee to Preserve Social Security and Medicare. Cutting contributions to Social Security signals the beginning of the end. Payroll tax holiday is anything but. And this is what they say. This comes from now Barbara Kennelly. Barbara used to serve in the House of Representatives. I've known Barbara for years. She's now the president and CEO of the National Committee to Preserve Social Security, one of the strong senior groups in America. And this is what Barbara says, and I quote, "Even though Social Security contributed nothing to the current economic crisis, it has been bartered in a deal that provides deficit-busting tax cuts for the wealthy. Diverting $120 billion in Social Security contributions for a so-called tax holiday may sound like a good deal for workers now, but it's bad business for the program that a majority of middle-class seniors will rely upon in the future." And that's what the National Committee to Preserve Social Security and Medicare says about that agreement, and I agree with them. So for all of us, who understand that Social Security is life and death for tens of millions of Americans today and will be vitally important for working people as they reach retirement age, that we understand that Social Security has done a great job. You know, Mr. President, a few minutes ago you were on the floor talking about the strong work that our federal employees do, and you're absolutely right. Sometimes we also take for granted that Social Security has been an enormous success. It has done exactly what those people who created it wanted it to do. Nothing more, nothing less. It succeeded. It has taken millions and millions of seniors out of poverty, given them an element of security. It has also helped people with disabilities maintain their dignity. Widows and orphans are also getting help. For 75 years, it has worked well. It has a $2.6 trillion surplus today, and it can pay out benefits for the next 29 years. It is strong. We want to make it stronger. This payroll tax holiday, I'm afraid, is a step very much in the wrong direction, and that is one of the important reasons why this agreement between the president and the Republicans should be defeated. Mr. President, included in the agreement are a number of business tax cuts. And I'm not going to be here to say that some of them may not work. Some of them may work. Some of them will work better than others, the whole list of them. But this is what I will say. Economists on both ends of the political spectrum believe that if we are serious about addressing the horrendous economic crisis that we're in now, 9.8% unemployment, that there are far more effective ways of creating the jobs that we have to create than those tax proposals. With corporate America already sitting on close to $2 trillion cash on hand, it's not that our friends in corporate America don't have any money. We've got to help them. They've got $2 trillion cash on hand. The problem is not, in my view, that corporate taxes are too high. It is that the middle class simply doesn't have the money to purchase the goods and products that make our economy go and create jobs. So I think that if our goal is to create the millions and millions of jobs that we need, and if our goal is to make our country stronger internationally in a very tough global economy, I would much prefer, and I think most economists would agree with me, that a better way to do that, to create the millions of jobs we've got to create, is to invest heavily in our infrastructure. Now, the truth is, and I don't think anyone disputes this, the infrastructure in the United States is crumbling, and I'll go into more detail about that later. Got some very good information on it. But, you know, you don't have to be a civil engineer to know that. All you have to do is get in your car today and drive someplace. And in my state and all over this country, what you are going to see are roads that are in disrepair. You're going to see bridges that in some cases have actually been shut down. You're going to see water systems. I remember, Mr. President, I was in Rutland, Vermont, the second or third largest city in the state of Vermont. And the mayor there showed me a piece of pipe. It's very funny. It's an old pipe. And he said, you know, the engineer who helped develop this water system and laid this pipe, he went off after he did this work for Rutland. He went off to fight in the war. And I knew there was a catch line coming. I said, well, what war was that? And he said it was the Civil War. So you're talking about water pipe being laid in Rutland, Vermont, and this is true all over the United States, laid in the Civil War. And the result is we lose an enormous amount of clean water every day through leaks, water pipes bursting every day, all over the United States of America. But we can put people to work improving our water system, our wastewater plants, very expensive proposition to develop good wastewater plants. I was a mayor, you were a governor. It is an expensive proposition. Roads, bridges. Furthermore, Mr. President, I don't have to tell anybody here, our rail system, which used to be the greatest rail system in the world, is now falling way behind every other major country on Earth. In Vermont, as a result of the stimulus package, which did a whole lot of very good things in the state of Vermont, one of the things we're able to do is use $50 million of federal fund, private money, to make major repairs on one of our important railways in the state. But we remain far behind most other countries around the industrialized world. China is exploding in terms of the number of high-speed rail lines that they have. We have got to do better. Our airports need work. Our air controllers need to be updated in terms of the technology they use to make our flights safe. And the point here is that what most economists would tell you is, A, when you invest in infrastructure, you got a bigger bang for the buck, you create more jobs for your investment than in most instances giving a variety of tax breaks to the corporate world. And second of all, and not unimportantly, when you invest in infrastructure, you are improving the future of this country. You're making us more productive. It's not just creating jobs, it's creating jobs for a very specific purpose, which makes our nation more productive and efficient. And thirdly, let me tell you something, as a former mayor, infrastructure does not get better if you ignore it. You know, you could turn your back if you're a mayor or governor on the roads and on the highways because you don't have the money to fix them today. They ain't going to get better next year. At some point, they're going to have to be repaired and fixed, and we may as well do that right now. So I believe that the money, the very substantial sums of money in this agreement between the president and the Republicans, which goes into tax breaks for corporate America, could be much better spent, more effectively spent on the infrastructure. Point I want to make in opposition to this agreement is that what we have heard from the president and others is that, look, this is a compromise. You can't get everything you want. Can't get everything what you want around here. That's true. But one of the examples of the compromise is an extension of unemployment benefits for 13 months. Well, let me be very, very clear. In the midst of a serious and major recession, at a time when millions of our fellow Americans are not only out of work through no fault of their own, but they have been out of work for a very, very long time. It would be, in my view, immoral and wrong to turn our backs on those workers. Their unemployment benefits are going to be running out soon, and it is absolutely imperative that we extend those unemployment benefits for the 2 million workers who would lose them. But here's the point that I want to make, Mr. President. Some people say that this is a compromise. Well, the Republicans gave on unemployment, the president gave on extending tax breaks for the rich, etc., etc. But here's the point. I don't believe, honestly, that the Republican support now for extending unemployment benefits really constitutes much of a compromise. Because the truth of the matter is that for the past 40 years, under both Democratic and Republican administrations, under the leadership in the Senate and the House of Democrats or Republicans, it has been bipartisan policy that whenever the unemployment rate has been above 7.2%, unemployment insurance has always been extended. So what you have had is longstanding bipartisan policy. That's what we have always done. That is what we should be doing in the future. I do not regard that Republicans now supporting what their party has always supported, extending unemployment benefits when unemployment becomes very high. I don't see that as a compromise. I see that as what has been going on in this country and in the Senate for 4 decades. Now, Mr. President, I've talked about the negative aspects of this proposal, but I am going to be the first to admit that, of course, there are positive and good agreements in this. And what are they? What are some of the positive aspects of this agreement? Let me just tick them off. Number one, I believe very strongly, and I know the president does, that it is absolutely imperative that we extend middle-class tax cuts for 98% of the American people. I don't think there's been any debate about that. When median family income has gone down by over $2,000 during the Bush years, when millions of our people today are working longer hours for low wages, when people can't afford to send their kids to college or take care of child care, I think it makes absolute sense. I don't think anyone denies that it is absolutely imperative that we extend middle-class tax cuts, and that's what this provision does, and that's the right thing. Furthermore, in this agreement, we have an extension of the earned income tax credit to working Americans, and the child and college tax credits are also in there. Every one of these agreements is very, very important. These programs will keep millions of Americans from slipping out of the middle class and into poverty, and they will allow millions of Americans to send their kids to college. So I'm not here to say that there is not anything of value in this agreement between the president and the Republicans. They are. And we have got to fight to make sure that all of those programs remain in the final package when it is passed, when the final package is passed. But when we look at the overall agreement, we must put it in a broader context, and that is, what will the passage of this legislation mean for the future of our country? And in that area, if you look at it in that context, I think the evidence is pretty strong that it is just not a good agreement and not something that should be passed. Mr. President, passage of this agreement would mean that we would continue the Bush policy of trickle-down economics for at least two more years. And that is not a good thing to do, because I think, as most Americans know, that philosophy, that economic approach, simply did not work. The evidence is quite overwhelming. I don't think there's much debate. When median family income during Bush's 8 years goes down by $2,200, when we end up losing over 600,000 private sector jobs, and all of the job growth was in the federal level, I don't see how anybody would want to continue that philosophy. But that, in essence, is what will happen if this agreement is passed. Now, I want to say make another point here about what happens if, and I will do my best to prevent this from happening, but what would happen if this agreement would pass? Does anybody seriously believe that our Republican colleagues would then say, oh, okay, well, we've got an extension of tax breaks for the very richest people. We've lowered the tax rate on the estate tax. Those are good victories for millionaires and billionaires, and we're going to go home now. We're not going to continue the fight. I don't think so. I don't think so at all. We're already hearing soundings about where our Republican friends want to go. The president put together what I thought was a very poor deficit reduction commission. I thought that the folks on it were not reflective of the American people. I thought there was a very much big business, corporate partiality. And the initiatives that came out of that commission, which fortunately did not get the 14 votes they needed, suggest to me that those of us who are concerned about protecting the needs of the middle class and working families, we are going to have to be pushing back pretty, pretty hard for what's coming down the pike. I think that what we will be seeing is that if this proposal negotiated between the president and the Republicans is passed, what you will be seeing within a few months are folks coming here on the floor of the Senate, and this is what they'll say. They'll say, you know what? Deficit is high, national debt is too high, and yes, oh yes, we drove the national debt up by giving tax breaks to billionaires, but that's the way it goes. But we're going to have to deal with that national debt. And then the Republicans will tell us, we have a great way to deal with it. We've given tax breaks to billionaires, but now what we're going to have to do is start making deep cuts in Social Security. And that Deficit Reduction Commission started paving the way for that. Very substantial cuts in Social Security. Maybe we'll have to raise the retirement age in Social Security for 69 or 70. Maybe we'll have to make cuts in Medicare. Maybe we'll have to make cuts in Medicaid. And I think we're beginning to see in the state of Arizona now what goes on when you make deep, deep cuts in Arizona, in Medicaid. In Arizona right now, there are people who are in line who need transplants, who will die if they don't get transplants. And in Arizona, as a result of legislation that they passed there, they're saying to people, young people, sorry, we can't afford to give you the transplant, and you're going to have to die. Well, is that what we're looking forward to seeing all over America? I certainly will do everything I can to prevent that. We're certainly going to see attacks on environmental protection, on education. Some of us believe that if this country is going to prosper, succeed in the global economy, we've got to have the best educational system in the world, from childcare through college. Right now, it is extremely difficult for middle-class families to send their kids to college. Does anyone have any doubt whatsoever that our Republican friends are not going to come back here and say, oh, we can't afford to raise Pell Grants as we have in recent years? We can't afford to support working families who are having their kids in childcare. Cut, 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 cut. That is in fairness to them. They've been pretty honest about it. So I would suggest, Mr. President, that if their argument is that we have a high deficit and a high national debt, that if we pass this agreement and the national debt goes higher, it only gives them more impetus to go forward to cut programs that benefit working families and the middle class. And let me also say that there is no doubt in my mind what many of, not all, but many of my Republican colleagues want to do. And that is, they want to move this country back into the 1920s, when essentially we had an economic and political system which was controlled by big money interests, where working people in the middle class had no programs to sustain them when things got bad, when they got old, when they got sick, when labor unions were very hard to come by because of anti-worker legislation. And that's what they want. They don't believe in things like the Environmental Protection Agency. They don't believe in things like Social Security, Medicare, Medicaid, federal aid to education. And that is the fight that...
All righty.
What's up, gamers?
We can use the word now.
Not banned.
You can tape it in the chat.
Yeah. Oh, do be careful. Our benevolent overlords that run this channel will ban it if we overuse it.
I see. All right, well, on to the introduction. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, to our 11th match of Gamer City League Season 2. Tonight we have Law versus Golden Gamers. Very interesting match. I feel like it's more interesting since we have a new player joining us for the first time. New mid laner for Team Law, and his name is Derek. We get to see how he does on the pro stage. Any thoughts, boys?
Absolutely none. Let's move on.
You think there's any thoughts going in here?
Yeah.
Well, it looks like.
Let's go. Predictions are live, boys. Everyone.
Make sure you gamble all of your gamer points for that Larkin body.
From my professional opinion, I think that today's game will be the first for Golden Gamers. Everyone vote for Golden Gamers.
Golden Gamers is coming up extremely strong in the polls as well, if you could take note.
I know.
All right. It looks like we've got a spectate link to the pro draft.
Dude, I have put stock on, so I don't have a dog barking in the background just in case anytime it happens.
All right. I got you. All right. Well, we're in the pro draft. Nothing's going on yet, but I feel like the bands that I'm waiting to see are pretty straightforward. I feel like GG's going to prio ban. The Fiddlesticks. I mean, I don't know. It doesn't seem like they watch a lot of other people's games. They kind of just wait to see what they what shows up, and then they ban like reactively in a sense. So not too sure what they're gonna ban.
I think they come in with their own builds, like, or their own champions in mind, and then they just kind of react, as you said. I don't think they come with anything.
I know Naz said earlier that he was gonna go all in on Law, so
Please vote for Golden Gamers.
well, this is, if you believe in the comeback story, this is it. This is your chance to make millions.
This is true. These odds are insane. What are the odds right now? All right, you get 1 to 17 and a half return ratio. Pretty crazy. But back to the bans. Predicting Larkin's gonna ban. I feel like a lot of teams, like, once one team gets a good ban off, a lot of teams sort of replicate that. So I know for a fact that, like, banning the Aphelios and especially the Kai'Sa since they're red side this first game is a very good idea for Team Law. Other than that, I mean, they can always target ban
Feel like they're always gonna,
Thomas.
with a Jace pick as well.
That's never happening, dude.
Oh, it
Yeah, I
looks
don't think
like they're
he's ever getting
starting.
Jace. Oh, they're starting the picks? Yes,
GG
sir.
has banned
First being
Tristana.
Tristana. Well, yeah, okay. Very interesting. I know Elijah plays a lot of Tristana, so it's kind of weird to see that ban come out. The Sylas ban, yeah, okay. So Dixon plays a lot of Sylas mid. That's one of his best champions, so it's not a very surprising ban.
Leona ban. I do know Leona has been quite a provocative support for Law here.
Nice wording. Okay. All right. Well, it seems as though I've not gotten any of the bans correct. Because they chose to opt for a Vayne Tristana ban on the side of GG. Law leaving the Kai'Sa up. I guess Larkin's just so confident that he can beat him on one of his main picks. Kind of beat him.
Oh, what is his main pick besides Trist, Vayne, Kai'Sa? Does he go Caitlyn here?
And he
He can go
does play Caitlyn, or if
Caitlyn, yeah.
he's feeling super
He can
just
also go
farm friendly,
Xayah.
just Sivir all day.
Oh, Sivir's pretty boosted. I feel like he plays a lot of ADCs. Like, he can even go fucking Kalista and do well. Like,
Oh yeah, I forgot his Kalista Thresh plays.
this is crazy. The Cho'Gath picked, I believe that's the top lane Cho'Gath for
Yeah, five
Ben.
for Ben. That's
Yep.
pretty good on the Cho'Gath.
Yeah, I
Very
was watching the game
comfortable.
last week. He did
He
pretty
picked the
good.
Fiddlesticks up.
Fiddlesticks
Okay,
pick for
they
Stu,
prio
listen.
picked the Fiddlesticks might hurt them because now they have to pick an ADC, and Team GG is able to sort of target ban their support. They still don't know what this guy plays mid lane. I think I checked out his OP.GG, and so he plays a lot of Caitlyn. So I don't know if they're gonna go for that ban.
Caitlyn mid lane?
Caitlyn mid?
In
Whatever.
Katarina?
Katarina. Sorry.
Katarina, okay, big difference.
Nah, not really.
Katarina is so fucking annoying, man.
It
Looks like an orange top. I remember hearing things that this is a spicy matchup when it was last played, but we have seen the Cho'Gath Ornn. I believe it was Ben's Cho'Gath into Thomas's Ornn was the last one we saw. God, that was a while ago.
We know the. Oh, yeah, I remember now. Hey, didn't I play against an Ornn one game, like last week? I think when I played
Probably.
Cho'Gath, I versed against an Ornn. I forget which team.
Didn't we verse Dixon's team last week?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, so it was Juan's Ornn. Yeah, he's pretty comfortable on the Ornn pick. So it's not bad that they're, he's actually able to get it. The Ornn against Cho'Gath. It's a skill matchup, but it's a little bit more favored towards the Cho'Gath, just because Cho'Gath have so much damage early on.
Also, don't let the FOMO get to you once Golden Gamers get into the, they start riding up knots.
And it looks like Akella took Thresh support.
Caitlyn ban.
Yeah.
They actually left ADC till second rotation.
They're legit gonna ban all the good ADCs. I wonder why they did that. Veigar ban. Interesting. I feel like Dixon plays like so many different mid laners that it's like, unless you're banning the Sylas, it's kind of hard to know what he's gonna pick, you know? I could pick Brand.
Nivea ban as well.
Super weird. Yeah, Nivea? Yeah. I guess. I mean, Nivea pretty boosted.
Nivea is fun as shit, dude. And she's easy.
Nivea's basically just ER immediately after. That's a big chunk. You Q him, try to run away. Maybe you get the extra Q. And you
it looks
EM.
Like
it's just
Larkin's
chunks.
Wow, they actually let the Jinx go through. Jinx is kind of busted right now.
Well, Jinx late game shreds. So that Ornn and Nautilus are not safe if this game goes to 40 minutes.
But I think Nautilus has a better chance against Thresh because he could just drop the ult from behind and just come
this
in.
This is true. The Nautilus does give a lot of utility with that point and click ult CC, but I mean, he's just going to build a Quicksilver Sash. So.
Though this Akali does look like it's going to be running down our Jinx.
You'll have to pay the tax then.
Friends here. Just
the Vi pick on to Robert. Pretty crazy.
They had Bolivar up, didn't they? I feel like Bolivar would have been good here. Maybe too tanky.
The Vi and the Nautilus showing good pick potential.
Are they going to pick mid? Kel was saying Aesol's open. If he picks Aesol right now, bro, I'm leaving. I'm going to ask Connor to reset the predictions. Okay, pick Katarina. It's okay.
You just already see these level 6 engages happening with Vi and Nautilus just going poorly for anyone to go up against.
I'm saying if you pick the Aesol, resetting the predictions might have been a good idea.
Alright, they picked the Katarina. Alright, yeah, I was thinking that.
I actually am low-key regretting putting all my money in on Law, because as I'm reading the chat, it seems like they might troll.
No, it's just the first game, then they go back to their roots, and they'll just win everything up.
What do you mean, Law trolling? They would never.
I put my life savings in here, if you can hear me, Law.
These are for Law to lose, man. This is big boy.
If you lose this game, we're gonna beat you, Arine. We're gonna knock
you
out of this tournament.
I just put another 150 of my channel points down.
150?
I put down 12k.
I put down 3k.
I know where you live, Larkin. If you lose this,
let's just say I'm gonna pay your family a visit.
Whoa. If he loses this, I pay the man a visit. I'm going through the wall.
You'll be getting a visit from the manager of Marcello's.
Oh, true.
Yeah. If they lose, we're gonna send Jake to steal the body pillow. Hold it for ransom.
True.
Because I'm gonna need those gamer points back.
We can't do that.
It is Thomas's.
We'll give it to Thomas.
So we can't.
The pillow printer just went off once.
Ooh, did they spell anything out here?
It says I didn't.
Can you just print gamer points? What's going on?
It
it's kind of sad because it removes the fun of earning them yourself.
Other bands.
Yeah, you're
That's such a great amount.
Yes, sir.
Is this one already added onto the Discord server?
It's not, but it really should be.
Clean. Sheesh. All right, well, here's how I'm thinking these matchups are going to go. I'm going to go lane by lane, break it down for everyone in the chat. Silver three person casting right now. Game knowledge is definitely up there. Top lane, I'm betting it's going to be a stalemate. Even if anybody wins that top lane, Nothing's gonna happen. It's two tanks beating the fuck out of each other. Who cares?
The wet noodle fight TM.
What?
It's gonna be wet noodle fight TM.
Facts. Jungle. I feel like jungle depends super heavily on bot lane, since I'm pretty sure that's where they're gonna be sort of camping in a sense. Bot lane and mid.
I see heavily contested top lanes. Just getting cracked. Between the percent damage on both Cho'Gath and Vi, it should be easy to take him down. Plus all that heavy CC they can bring onto him.
Yeah, but it depends. The way Juan plays, he might play super safe if he's afraid he's going to get ganked. It's kind of hard to catch out a fucking Ornn unless he wastes everything.
No,
it's
slippery. Talking about Ornn onto the Cho'Gath.
Oh, Ornn, Vi onto Cho'Gath? Yeah, that's quite the possibility.
Let's not talk about any things pertaining to that though. We gotta keep our high mindsets for both teams here.
The mid lane matchup, I don't know how this Katarina plays. I know that Dixon's
I'm stressing over these points already.
You're stressing.
Oh no.
Oh yeah. Very excited to see what this mid lane turns out as, because I don't know how Derek is. I think his name is Derek. Please. Bot lane, I think that Elijah might win this one. Kai'Sa Nautilus is pretty strong.
No, they're definitely just gonna play far back. Lorcan is obviously a consistent player. He just managed to farm up and stay alive. And if opportunity presents itself, he's like a catfish, he just snaps up from underneath and just grabs
it. Yeah, Larkin plays extremely safe. There's a little bit of a meme that he first buys tabbies back when that was an item. So
back when that was actually OP, he used to do that all the time. Tristana first buy tabbies. Never forget.
Yep.
But possible outplay potential with the Kai'Sa ult. Maybe she'd get the big shield, get off the percent damage proc, and then just happy days and run away.
I want to see some fat.
Now, what I'm curious about is, I'm curious about this mid lane assassin v assassin.
Yeah, it's whoever can slam their fist onto their keyboard the fastest.
True.
Big facts.
Yeah.
Those
will also be interesting for team fights later in the game.
Do you count any solo kills happening early in mid lane? I think I can almost
I have actually no idea.
I smell it in the air.
You smell it?
The bloodlust of these hungry mid laners.
All I smell right now?
The late mid coming in early to try and prove himself and swiftly.
Listen, if they're Chad, they both got what the fuck is that item, dude? The ring.
Not Dark Seal.
Dark Seal. Yeah, if they're both Chad, they build Dark Seal.
It's the only thing to buy.
I can already smell it. The stopwatch coming in for the outplay.
All right, and who wins the skin match here?
I think it's pretty apparent. Team 5-3. The TP ignite Katarina balls to the wall. Like this.
I mean, it makes sense. If you die, you just get back quicker and you kill them before they get back. You know, it's just big brain plays.
You don't need flash on Katarina.
Enable yourself
like
to get further leads by getting shutdowns on yourself.
Bro, I got lasagna in front of me right now. Fuck.
You can get the League and ASMR stream.
Hold on.
That shit bossing.
Yeah, we're stuck out and we just loaded in.
Tell us when to go.
I just loaded in. Time is 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 seconds. Has everyone, roughly the same time?
Yeah.
Okay.
Get your shit behind it. Please.
Welcome to Summoner's Rift.
Elite Meh, yes. Twitch can read all chat.
Yeah, they're 3 minutes behind, yeah. Jake.
I'm just I think letting whatever everyone he said know here in Twitch.
Is yo. Hog.
Two.
Looks like no spicy early game plays out of anyone here.
That's pretty good. Alright, so predictions are gonna be gone in 3 minutes.
Oh! Yo! The Katarina put the fucking...
Alright, predictions are closing. Hurry up and vote for GG, guys. Hurry, vote.
Alright, I just put down 1,600 points on Law.
Nice. Well, it seems as though my prediction was correct. The Katarina did, in fact, go Darkseal. Pretty pog. That's what I like to see. Sucks that Dixon's not chad enough to do the same.
They went Dorn Shield, what a fucking minimum.
Alright. Jurassic Cho'Gath is a pretty skin, I'll be honest. It's been a while since I've seen a Jinx in lane before. Very interesting. And a breath of fresh air when it comes to this ADC meta.
That's right, in this tournament I don't think anyone's played Jinx yet.
Yeah, Jinx. Bomb has been heavily dominated by Kai'Sa's and Vayne's and other
Caitlyn's.
I think I've seen a lot of couple of Jinx.
Scrap happening in the bot lane. The Ignite going on to Zachary. Same thing happening in the mid lane.
Scrap. Oh, mid lane
first blood
going
to the
Oh, there it goes.
Katarina! What's his name?
Katarina's Dark Shield.
They're getting
sense,
the first blood. Looks like bot lane's gonna lose this. Alright, well, bot lane, a bit of a big trade going on. A lot of sums wasted there. It seems as though they weren't able to focus on one target. And, the kill went over to the Nautilus, so it's not, like, super bad.
That's pretty good. Also, what's his face? Dirk got the first blood mid
with the Darkseal. Chad.
Arena's coming in clutch this time around. He just bought his Amplifying Tome and Boots, and he's just gonna come in and do massive amounts of damage when he roams bot lane later.
He forced out Dixon's flash. Very critical. Top lane, they're hitting each other as per usual. Just really going at it. Oh, bot lane, the hook landing onto the Thresh. Thresh Flay misses a lot of damage going off. They're already chunked out. He just got back into lane.
Ooh,
it seems as a Vi is taking a trade.
Chasing down Stu.
I don't know if Katarina can follow.
Katarina might be able to do some crazy plays.
Maybe.
The hook landing onto the Nautilus in the bot lane. Then the traps going up. This might be looking like a kill for Larkin here.
Yeah, this looks like a fair kill for Lord Paleskin going down right here.
Nice.
Yes, Pugsassy scaling.
I mean, to be fair, he shouldn't really be that far up without his ADC. He was in the bush backing. It's just that
unlucky
because they knew he was in the bush. You know. He was able to get the easy hook off.
Unlucky, actually.
Yeah, indeed.
Well, it looks like those predictions are safe, huh, boys?
As the game is still very early on. Okay.
Always losable.
I don't know what that was in the mid lane, but it looked cool.
It was a little something.
Dude, actually gonna have to ban Katarina, bro.
God, I hate that champion.
I'm 440.
1, 2,
2, yeah.
3. Dragon's coming up in 10 seconds.
It'll be both, an ocean drake.
Vi is in the bot lane, and it seems like Fiddle is still in base.
They definitely want this early ocean drake, considering that they have Cho'Gath, who's just going to become a massive wall of flesh.
Though Katarina might spot out. Yep, she spots out the Vi's bot.
Vi's, yeah. They should have been aware of her being there as well. Stu's also coming down. They're starting side of jungle.
Katarina can potentially come down bot. the hook landing onto the Thresh again.
Yeah, the Caterina's not gonna come and clean us up. They're just playing for time here. They want to act.
Threads the needle with that hook.
No, Caterina just flay going right on. Back around.
The ignite. I think the ignite ticks. Oh, the flash.
Does Larkin get
and he died. Blocks the hook. Vi is coming up, but it's too late. As soon as.
Far too late. Just backs. Vi knew it was already nothing she could do.
It looked pretty good. And then they just kind of fucked it.
I mean, it's just insane.
Oh my goodness, almost solo kill coming out if it had been for that.
Wow, Katarina actually, like, looks like counters Akali pretty good.
Pretty well.
Okay.
Yeah. Wow, okay, so finally opting not to take the dragon after the double kill.
We have three
Roman bones. Greedy ADC wants to get that good back instead of helping his team out with objectives.
Juan's being pushed in now.
That's what I was talking about. That damage from Cho'Gath is no joke.
Yeah,
Juan is super low on mana.
CS after CS, he just gets more and more HP mana. Just
Daddy Cho.
Cho'Gath looking not very thick. He's looking super bony today, but.
Don't worry, he'll get girthy later.
This bone's gonna get full of calcium. Yeah. Your milk.
Just gotta wash that chomp, baby.
Bags.
Roaming a Akali. God, there's no dust.
True.
Let's see what she comes
to. Steal the blue buff?
Yeah, maybe. No. Doesn't seem like it.
Just waits for the jungler with the blue buff?
No.
Jungler's on
meanwhile,
the opposite
top side
of the bucket.
Yeah. Little do they know.
I just don't think he knows that, though. I think he's just sitting
there
just
waiting
for someone to
come
back.
She's losing so much in the mid lane for something that's not
going to
come.
Initiating a trade again. Everything going on to the Kai'Sa. TP coming from mid lane? Oh,
yeah, that's
interesting.
Ignite.
And he's...
Well, Kellua seems like he might be a little bit too far up.
Akali's right behind.
Katarina's just going to hit that.
Here comes Akali.
Dagger.
Two flashes. Oh, this is it. Good stuff coming
there
in
from
Akali.
Akali coming in from behind, R2-ing the Jinx.
Meanwhile,
she have a bounty
right there.
Blue side, maybe.
Oh, but
I mean, two for one.
Here comes Vi behind.
Vi's not
turn around.
Vi's level 5? Oh no, this is not good.
Oh boy,
he gets more. The quadra kill.
Well, and the TP shot from Cho'Gath.
I don't know if that was a fantastic
game to pick up the Katarina. Everyone's just so squishy.
He's just getting turret plates.
He gets the turret plates. Very bad TP
by Ben
right here. He's gonna lose a lot in this top lane.
I mean, fuck it, right? They basically got 4 kills onto what's his face, Katarina.
Yeah.
In the bot lane.
Katarina's looking
10 stack Darksteel.
The Darksteel's looking quite full.
At 8. Basically 9 minutes into the fucking game, it's a fully stacked Darksteel. I think the game is over.
It's not as over till it's over, but it's looking quite over.
Ooh, might have a bit of a duel here between Vi and Stubaka.
Maybe we have the old Zerok coming with the puncheroos.
He's going in. A lot of damage. Oh, the forces the flash. You gotta get out of there. He's coming!
He's
gonna get the kill, but like...
Cajones for
the
weakness.
But that... You're just transferring double buffs onto the mid laner.
It was the plan all along.
The hook in the bot lane. Another kill going on to Larkin.
Red side is just looking super dominant.
There's no way Dix takes that.
I think... If I was blue side, I might FF.
A blue side would FF 15 if they're... Just continue.
It's never over till it's over, Arlen.
Always losable.
Very true. Always losable.
I need my body pillow.
I'm looking at the top one at the moment.
The bot lane's looking like something spicy might occur right now. Oh, they might have bit off more than they could chew here.
Yes.
Goodbye, Larkin.
Larkin with the one shot.
Larkin does get it, though.
Oh, Larkin really hoping he would have got the crit off earlier.
Bro, what the fuck?
The flash from Juan, I don't think that Q would have killed him, bro.
He actually stops the TP from going to bot lane. I mean, not that it would have done anything.
He
honestly
might have,
like, maybe he should have let the TP go through so that he gets more
Still potentially trading the Herald for the Dragon here, say.
Potentially, but it doesn't look like Robert's going for the Dragon.
Yeah, I'll...
It doesn't look like Robert really has a prio.
Absolutely no vision.
Robert,
top
I don't think that you win that. Oh, and you kill your mid laner as well. Crazy hook from the bush. Oh, but the bot lane's walking up. This might be. Okay. This might be a kill. Oh wait, that was Kelwa walking up. I thought that was Katarina. Yo, he actually walks away.
The Kaiser W comes
out. Not if the W comes out. Oh, he just
cues.
Yeah.
And who gets the Herald?
Yes, who gets a Herald
nothing
for free.
Kind of
crazy. 11 minutes. This drag has still not taken. Pox actually sees Lord Paleskin walking down. Doesn't do anything. Wow.
He knows better. He knows the information's worth.
Now, does he do something nice and place a ward here? No, he doesn't.
Hopefully, he takes the blue buff himself instead.
Guys, let's make bets. Does Larkin get more than a 15 vision score this entire game? Probably not.
He's got both wards, though. He's not placed a single ward this whole game.
He's saving them for the to use them situationally to get good vision around for a team fight, I would imagine.
Yeah, saving them for next game. Yeah.
Yeah. Afraid of running out this early in the game, huh?
And it looks like
they're
posturing here is
for Drake.
Up the dragon.
They're just gonna have to give it. There's no way you fight with a 7-0 Ketamine with 10 stacks on that Dark Seal already completed Nashor's Tooth. Stew you lagging, says Dixon. A little bit of, I don't know if that's BM.
She
might be lagging
though.
Like, we
missing
we know Stew's history.
Of her own ping that she could have done.
Stu's history is that she's known as a lagger.
When Stu was on my team for a brief time, it'd be her ping would just skyrocket for minutes on end and just fall down like nothing ever happened.
Oh, this is looking at a 4-man dive in the bot lane. Oh,
drop
guys, get out of there!
Little did you know the Akali's coming up from
Herald.
Oh, boy.
Stu is losing her jungle though here.
Afraid at all.
I don't think the Herald
is
good. I don't think they go for this. You guys got
there's the ult. No, she just.
You guys lose this.
This is looking.
Yeah, the Fiddlesticks ult kind of just chunks them. Okay, the. The
how do you
Jinx
miss three
ult.
Targets like that, bro.
Throwing wide. Look at this. Look at this. Look at the instant replay. Oh my god. Oh my god.
Oh my.
Oh, he actually backs in their face. Chad, super Chad right there.
They might just try and push for a second slam out of the Herald just to make him pay for that.
They get the last pay for charge.
Wow.
Oh my.
13
and
minutes
they have
in.
Already knocking on a tier 1.
Yeah. And another Herald coming up in 3 minutes. If they keep this dominance, they'll just be inside by like 17.
They are already.
Oh, is this a kill in the top lane? Oh, no, he is not.
Seems as though top lane, even CS, even score.
Top lane is an island, don't even
know. Nothing really happened. The hook going wide in the mid lane. Oh, okay.
I said Katarina plays being made.
Ballsy.
Lantern's being thrown.
Oh, Hex, it gets the shutdown. It's 1,000 gold shutdown. Very, very ambitious. Does not pay off. Definitely not worth. He loses stacks, gives 1,000 gold to the Akali.
Not
gives
really
him
fresh,
1,000 gold shutdown. It's still nearly a 5k gold diff.
No, no, but the Akali got killed.
Oh, yeah, right, right. I'm just.
Did the Thresh get the kill?
No.
On the
Akali, yeah.
Vi needs to leave.
I'm just.
Larkin actually places a pink ward down. Please record this moment in history. Guys,
oh
he has 2 vision score. Okay. Right now, Robert is going to... Oh, Robert, you don't go in on this. Robert is dead here.
Deeply
has to burn
decisions.
The flash to get out.
He's saying, oh, guys, look at this damage. Beware.
Yeah, Jinx is, in fact, scaling. Hook goes wide.
I think
definitely
be
not the same machine that we saw on the Blitzcrank.
Go down with the Ornn, the voltage is so big, it's gonna stun, brittle everybody. You'd be able to get the percent damage out and start chunking some of those teammates.
Yeah, but so far, Ornn
and Cho'Gath have been nowhere on
They've
the map.
They've been absent for each team fight so far.
Well, I mean, Cho'Gath did TP after the fight.
The bot lane, yeah, he was. Time. Oh, that was. He came in and just backed immediately.
No, he actually he didn't even TP down there. I don't know if you noticed.
Oh, he walked.
Stopped the TP.
Oh, did he? Yeah. I don't think you can cancel a TP.
Okay, so he, if you choose going off onto TP. Lord Paleskin, they might. Oh, they might go for the Jinx here.
Oh,
it's looking very Quan's promising. But there in. Is there is the Katarina coming from behind. They gotta focus it.
Oh my
Still
goodness.
Going off
oh, but Quan's here.
Zanya goes
save.
Golden. They're all so dead here. The ult coming down from Ornn.
Oh boy, there goes a brittle up on.
This is looking like a kill on to Stu. Stu ults from super far away. Okay, Quan going back in. He's not gonna die. Definitely did not need to flash there. You were pretty tanky, my brother. But I mean, you never know. That Katarina does do big boy damage.
Mm-hmm. Katarina's just like.
I don't know if you saw, but Larkin tried to heal Stu and missed it.
I mean, I don't think the heal would have done anything. I'm gonna be fully honest with you. I think that was a lot of damage.
Larkin's seen plenty of these moments go down. Sometimes you can't just
listen.
Save
they're giving up bounties, and they're giving up kills. This game is definitely not as bad as it was before.
See the gold diff, bro?
Yeah.
It's gold diff, but all that gold is on like one player.
True.
It's a 7k gold diff, bro.
Okay, it's
mid lane is up 2k, bot lane's up almost 2k.
Yeah. All
sports don't matter, so we don't really count the gold for them. What are they gonna do? Build more tanky items? Gaze.
Ooh, what we're
looking at here
the
is the
lane.
Mid lane and the bot lane. I mean, top lane is up 1,000 gold as well.
Okay. I wonder why Katarina's top though.
Like, I think they're both trying to split and just, you know, get even more.
I
fed.
Mean, Katarina being top here kind of gives them a good chance of like fighting this dragon. They should have went in on this. They could have taken
I
the
think
fight.
Thresh gave knowledge as to where they were, but they just can't go in without vision.
I spot a Nomad. Yep. But, oh, it's gonna be Infernal Soul.
Well, this Katarina's looking to have quite the game here, isn't she?
That's a fact. I mean, if it even goes to that long. I'm not sure if it might.
Have they taken the second Herald? Yeah. No, they're on it.
Katarina gets
this is looking
Void
like
staff?
The end of the game here. I think sure Cho'Gath is on bot lane, prepping the wave. They just head down there and clean it up. Or even if she somehow manages to die, she just comes right back with the TP. Just looking really bad.
They could potentially end the game with this fucking Herald.
Oh, they gotta be careful. They're... Wait.
Oh, they...
No, I also thought I saw it too, but no, the ult by Katarina end.
The ult by Robert a little too early onto the Katarina.
Oop, but here comes the Kali behind everyone.
Oh, the... Hook landing, Zacharias, Elijah is dead.
Balin's all prepped.
What? What just happened? He actually just... Dixon with the great escape. What is happening, bro? Dixon hiding behind the rocks. Dude's playing Metal Gear Solid out here.
They actually take bottom turret.
You think he's gonna drop
definitely
it?
Definitely didn't
yeah.
need to just give it to him. I mean, he's gonna get eaten here. Get some kills.
The TP
going from the Katarina.
Oh, that's... I thought it might be Troll, but then again, this Katarina is 11-1, 12-1.
Double kill. Keeps getting all the kills.
About to go 13.
Double knockup from the Cho'Gi right here.
Cho'Gath.
Yeah, honestly, the game might be over. They might just pop Herald. Oh, they did pop Herald.
Yep, they popped Herald. We might see Shelly dancing if we're lucky.
Might nah, definitely not.
It might be
Shelly's gonna get
shortest game this tournament.
Nah, Shelly died before we got to see her dance.
The ult coming from Ornn, gonna... Oh!
He missed the R2 with the hook.
They actually ended the game? Bro, what the fuck?
Can they end it before 20 minutes?
Yes, they can.
They actually ended
well, that's
before
the
20 minutes. That's crazy.
That is quite the dominance being displayed by Team Law.
Indeed it is. Also, that was quite a push there at the end. So how does GG respond to that this game?
All I
Katarina ban, right?
Katarina ban is looking like a definite.
Maybe don't ban the Tristana next time and focus on the Katarina.
I mean, they're probably gonna pick Cho'Gath in the top lane, right? You know that's gonna be a definite. So why don't you just pick a counter?
Yeah, but that's not the question. It's, does Juan play anything that can counter it effectively? Oh my God. Like, it's tank versus tank top lane. Top lane doesn't do anything. You know what I mean? It's kind of like that lane was just there. I didn't really see.
I think the only things that Cho'Gath really did towards the end there was tank for Katarina.
He ate Juan in that last fight. There.
Yeah, I mean, he ate Juan, but like, that was solo. Katarina TP'd in after, and he was able to tank a lot of the damage for her instead of, you know, all that damage happening on Katarina.
Yeah, kind of crazy.
Well, if you put your money on the Golden Gamers, you don't count yourself out quite yet. They might be coming back with a better draft.
Yeah, with a reverse sweep here.
Potentially.
Don't fool yourself. That 16 odd is, it's surely in your pocket as we speak. 16 to 1 on.
Damn. This game is nuts, to be honest.
I'm reading the chat here after that, but Lily did claim that Larkin's vision score was going to be 0, when in fact it was 2. He did actually play the control ward.
2 vision score!
The turnaround, huh?
Larkin bought 1 control ward that whole game.
Did he play any of his regular wards at all?
I think he might have.
He might have even just bought a blue trinket and not use it on him.
I don't know, dude, but that's crazy.
Perhaps we'll see the Caitlyn come out and maybe he'll have to break out the wards for the sake of getting those ults off at a distance. But let's see what's to come.
Game 1 is pretty tough for Golden Gamers. I kind of want to see them pull it around for game 2.
I definitely want to see some silver scrapes tonight.
Silver scrapes.
Yeah, it seems as though our management is
is complaining.
Evil Overlord Dictator is complaining. Don't mind him, viewers, even though you can't hear him. He's threatening to delete Arnold Pog. The travesty. Everyone, refund your subscriptions.
Mind you, that's not just an offense against the accused, but also the innocent Arnold. This is
that is innocent true. Here.
There's a fresh from the fire.
In the crossfire.
Yes.
It's crazy. Evil Overlord, you have stooped solo.
We're maybe about to call. I'm sure to make this joke up.
I'm eating some lasagna right now.
Hey. Lasagna, is it nice and baked down and reduced, or is it saucy and?
No, it's like cheesy.
Cheesy lasagna.
It's so good, so meaty.
I can't wait to.
It looks like we're discussing using Pro Draft, or
I may just go into it without using Pro Draft.
I personally hate Pro Draft.
No Pro Draft. We're doing this. We're going in dry.
It looks like it ain't the Pro Draft.
They have, in fact, used Pro Draft.
Pro Draft is so.
God damn it.
It's so lame.
It's like. It doesn't behave the same way as the client does.
It so doesn't.
Sometimes you find yourself like missing out on the last second picks.
Yeah. All right. And you've got a spectator link.
Oftentimes remedied by a quick old guys add something else in chat, but still, that shouldn't be the case. Let's see. Oh, now Larkin switching onto the blue side. Statistically. Higher likelihood of winning on the blue side, so
blue side is weaker, bro.
No, blue side is stronger. It is stronger. Statistically, I think by 1% or so.
Yes, something like. That's why everyone. Yeah,
It looks like GG did elect red side, by the way.
We should
have already said.
You know, it'd be crazy.
It'd be crazy if we hired an alt to obscure what the actual odds are to get better odds on our own. You know.
No, I'm saying for when we play our game. Maybe would it be crazy if we somehow lose the game? Not on purpose.
And the draft started. Stop talking about picks in the games.
To get more points. Gamer yes. coins.
The body pillow ain't coming easy. You gotta make it
well,
happen.
All right, we got a Thylas ban. Katarina ban.
Katarina ban's instant ban. That's pretty.
I wonder what the Seraphine ban just came on. Like, just keeps on coming out. Like.
Yeah, I mean, Seraphine support and
my
also mid
against
lane.
Golden Gamers support. Seraphine oftentimes fail to hit the mark with various ults. Just
I've seen it played like kind of well by other people.
True.
Kai'Sa ban and a Jinx
ban. And this is looking like
Malphite
it's
ban. Jinx probably gonna get
maybe
banned.
all the difference is gonna happen to the top lane. Maybe. Maybe he just pulls out something like a.
By the way, I think that Malphite ban is for Juan.
Yep.
Yes. Malphite is a very easy pick right now and provides a ton of utility for
instant
the team.
Cho'Gath.
Okay. Probably picking Cho'Gath. Kind of troll.
There's a reason
he
says rock solid. Because he's a rock solid pick.
No,
bro.
Not really.
You can never go wrong with him.
Yes, yeah, it's a troll pick. Ben's pretty good on it.
I'm saying prior picking it, I feel like in my opinion. I mean, I guess. I guess.
They're just
like,
going.
Can't really. There's no counter to that.
It just seems they're just going to try and
make
it as tough for me as it can.
If you
could give
me, if you pick the Aesol, that would be pretty pog.
Oh, the Aphelios coming out. This is.
Is that supposed to be Aphelios?
Elijah plays a lot of Aphelios.
Yeah.
He's pretty comfortable on it. I've seen the man go crazy stupid
I've
on it.
I've seen the man throw it back crazy stupid on you.
I feel like go burn.
Wait,
Nocturne.
Really? Tristana a Jinx
still
fan?
On the Nocturne.
Dude, I told her about the Nocturne pick the other day and I was doing poorly as her and she was like, I'll try it out. And then, you know, it's not a bad pick, but and I told her that in teamfight situations it'd be very... Oh, that's she's been practicing and that's good to see. No, she could just put in work. Yeah, they're gonna put in pressure heavy on him.
It's obvious they're trying.
Cowell to... back on Thresh.
A Poppy, Chad.
Wow, Poppy top, kind of crazy. What if this is Poppy jungle? I've seen it.
No, bro.
I've seen the Poppy jungle, and I know.
Really
I'm pretty sure. Doesn't Robert play
Mr.
Poppy
Robert
or is
it
Thomas?
Chad enough?
I don't know.
Yeah, dude. I thought Thomas was the Poppy player.
Ah.
So it seems like
Poppy top.
Let's
see if he says lies and slander here.
I mean,
Poppy actually works out pretty well because, like, the Nocturne goes in. Poppy's just, like, gearing up her ultimate, you know what I mean? And they just gotta, like, pop the spell shield and then Nocturne has a one way ticket back to the fountain.
On the pick. This is gonna be quite interesting considering that they have.
Right, they're banning Anivia and the Jinx. Okay. Three ADCs, yeah. Two mid laners. Alright. They ran back the same exact bans as last game.
Except the Katarina ban here instead of
Caitlyn. I'm saying on Team Law side.
Yeah, that is true. Exact same ban.
And the exact same rotation. Kind of crazy.
They're going to be. I wonder if they'll be picking up here. Maybe the Vayne?
Sejuani.
Oh, that is a Poppy top.
Vayne is looking like a huge possibility here. Three tanks so far.
Yeah. They were probably looking for the mid counter pick, but
maybe something unusual coming out from Mark. Maybe he's been practicing the Kog'Maw down on Modestes.
Oh yeah, the Pogma.
This is a Vayne game for you, Larkin. This is literally what every Vayne dreams of.
This is
tanks to go
classic
against.
Pick. He's like, well. I gotta see all this hard CC that can be thrown at me, so I just gotta play, farm up, and then, you know, we'll...
The Ivermaid! He said he would do it! Ivermaid!
What chat?
This is crazy.
Wait. Can Nocturne go mid or no?
No, definitely not Nocturne mid. I think okay. I think Stu's...
Nocturne can go mid.
Do you want to flex it?
I don't think Stu. No, Stu can't play.
Stu, I think Stu plays Ivern. Yeah, Stu's on
Stu
Ivern.
Yeah,
I'm pretty sure Stu does not play Ivern, but I've seen her misclick Ivern before.
That makes. Click it.
They picked the Renekton for mid lane. What is bro?
What
is this
maybe?
Misclick?
No AP. Poppy.
It's Galio.
Oh, okay.
That's what I say.
Well, that's just the highlight of what he stated earlier, where he just
actually makes runs
Galio.
Right out.
All right.
Do you think that double stuff Orioles is too much stuffing?
No.
I want to double stuff
it's
you.
It's not enough. It's not enough.
All right, well, looking at this draft, very interesting, to say the least.
Yeah.
We got the Galio mid with the three... this is like four tank combo.
It's like
right
Team
now.
Lodge
they're putting
China.
Everything onto the back of Elijah. He better have a motherfucking... He better bench...
Biggest
bench.
PP damage.
If it goes 1-1, one, one, we should probably open up another set of, you know, bets for the...
What the
you know, I've got a couple points in my pocket now just from watching the stream in the background.
Yeah.
And, you know, it just seems like
I mean, if we had predictions still available to us, I would like us to predict: does Larkin go above 2 vision score this game?
That's good.
Pull. Yeah,
okay.
Let's get it.
I would definitely bet on that.
Do we want to give some like predictions? Because I don't think it's gonna be more than 5. So like, do we want to go like 5 options
fact.
Here?
I think it's Larkin might hear this, so then he'll actually start warding.
Vision score 1, 2, 3, 4 5+.
Only up to five. That's it. Oh yeah, but the last one being 5+.
Yeah.
5+.
5+ is a.
Let's check it. Score. 5+.
I mean, guys, listen. Last game, his vision score was what? 2?
2.
Yeah.
I'm not putting
exactly.
2 again.
I'm thinking
an even 3. I'm putting an even 3. Can you even get to 3? Doesn't it skip from 2 to 4 like automatically? What are you talking about?
I'm going to 4. I mean, I think if you place a stealth ward, it's 1 vision score each. And a...
A pink ward only gives you vision score for how many minutes it's been up.
Yeah.
Pretty sure a pink ward has to see people, too.
Kelwa has a lot of faith in your ADC.
I think...
If Kelwa or Dirk actually said anything about the poll to Larkin... That's kind of
it's kind of rigged.
That is insider trading.
You better not say anything.
Larkin's not hearing this. He's too focused on the game.
No snitches, bro. No snitches.
Fact. Or being the top pick. Cringe. People are overhyping his vision score too much.
No, he's...
Listen, I can see him placing some blue wards for Baron or something. If
he's playing Sivir, so he's just going to be farming all game. It's a fact.
I
mean,
definitely
Larkin
not getting
flames
enough fire support for the poor vision score.
I don't think anyone on this team noticed his poor vision score.
They must have, like... That's all you pay attention to is support. You're like, am I losing vision score game? Or, like, what happened? Like, you have that... If you... The support... You don't have the highest vision score. You just kind of...
Okay, what'd you say? Evil Overlord?
Yes, our Evil Overlord, Benevolent Dictator, has informed us that 4 indeed won the poll.
Yeah, but let's see if they're right. Winning the poll doesn't necessarily mean you got the bag.
I better see some nasty skins on both.
No. Yeah, I want to see some Birdio here out of Godly RNG, aka Dixon.
We need to start plugging the league somewhere public so we can get some more points in predictions, because it's going to take way too long to hit the million.
That's the point.
By the way, it's 10 million.
I'm on that, bro.
10 million to redeem the Larkin body pillow.
Yes, 10 million.
Nine and a half years of straight up watching.
We need to plug in some more Riot merch here, guys. Riot does have a deal right now. If you donate plasma, you get the KDL Kaisa skin. If you're a real gamer, you'll do it.
Perhaps we can run reruns of the streams for people in other time zones.
Yo, Gamer City League is going to become the biggest streaming service on in Brazil, I think, right?
I think we're headed into like at least
not Brazil, like... bro. Anywhere but Brazil.
But they're in the southern hemisphere, though. I don't know.
Yeah, it's they're like in the southern. Problem. Isn't it nighttime in the southern?
Yeah, they're in the southern hemisphere. It's a different time zone.
Guys, it's for all my boys in Siberia watching the Gamer City League Season 2 Match 11.
This is for all my Albanian 6-year-olds watching with the bogeys in the back. I'm going to go on a water trip while this loads up. I'll be back in a moment.
A water trip. I hope he doesn't get lost. Oh, man.
All right, so we've got our spectator delay happening right now.
Yeah, spectator delay.
What does everyone
cringe.
Think of these picks? Like, how do we think this is going to go? Because this is a lot of tank on the team of GGs here.
Yeah, I don't see anything like that. But I mean, that also means that the Nocturne's not going to be doing a whole lot. Who are you going to assassinate?
No.
When everyone's stacked on the Aphelios?
Aphelios, because you're Nocturne. Not going to be able to see you coming.
Well, second the Nocturne ult goes off, everyone's going to group.
Yeah.
Yeah, so...
Doga could eat him, though.
Like I was saying.
Eat who? Eat somebody. Yeah, that's true, but like... They have a beefy fucking front line. How's Cho'Gath gonna get to the back without getting blasted?
Tell you right now, this Ivern's gonna do some mega damage.
He might go the support Ivern build.
Nah, if he's a Chad, he goes full damage.
Do we see any potential for like invades or anything happening?
I guess Ivern, Thresh, Sivir.
Definitely gonna be a strong invade potential because Stu could just run up on him, drop her Q, and it's gonna leave a trail of movement for her. So
they do want a game 3. Can my heart take a game 3? I'm not sure. If I lose all these points,
can a benevolent dictator take a game?
If GG hits the game 3, what if we get like 5 games? That'd be pretty. No. We can't do that. We should do
5 games.
I brain farted.
It was
game 3.
5 games is like that's like
finals. That's way too long. That's stressful.
They said that we're gonna do it for playoffs.
Yeah. Do they do best of 1?
We said playoffs is gonna be best of 5.
Like,
by the way,
hey, like professional sports do just 1 of 1 as well. Like,
yeah, but I mean professional sports games.
Yeah, no, what do you mean, bro?
Like,
this is
a lot
this
of
is
physical
just,
activity.
This is 4D chess here. This is like.
I mean, this is a lot of mental activity. I don't know
this
if
is, this is. This is like.
Basketball
this is like
or soccer dude, players could take it, bro.
League of Legends is like a mental Paralympics, bro. What?
That's a fact.
And
mental Paralympics. Spectator
delay comes to an end. We find out who won the skin game.
I mean, if you think about it, it takes a lot. It's a lot harder to play a best of 5 than an actual like soccer game or basketball game.
Mentally,
very true. I mean, it's harder for the average league player.
All right, let's just do a quick skin check.
No
bot lane
skin.
With the 3 skins, top 4 skins. It's looking like the
4
Oscar
skin.
Okay,
4v4. It's a tied game, boys and gals.
Is it 4?
I think so.
No Ivern skin. I might have to report this dude.
Whoa. The game is paused.
Game has been paused.
File missing persons report. Okay.
Dixon left the call.
Dixon seems to have had an oopsie. Perhaps his internet provider said it's too late for you to go to bed.
Parents ganked him.
The internet providers, yes.
He's back. He's back. He's back in the call, boys. This was, in fact, 3 minutes ago, so they're resuming.
Okay.
They're resuming without even saying R? Question mark?
Questionable? No, they have the 15-minute buffer, or the 15-second buffer before the gate opens and they're in.
Yeah, buffer. I went with the Ignite. Ignite comment, dude. He's not going fucking support Ivan. He's going balls to the wall.
We did not, like... They're all group mid. Maybe they go from, they went top. Can they catch the Poppy, perhaps?
Oh, they might catch Kelwa
should be in the lead here. Kelwa should be in the front.
The Ivan showed himself... Bro. Trolling? They actually had the monster.
Oh, and they counter invade in the bot side?
I think that was just a...
Oh my god, this is actually insane. Juan needs to not get spot out here, because then it's to tell. Oh, well, I'm so sure that he saw all of them.
He didn't. I don't think he has. Perhaps
I don't think he did.
There's a tier 3 group sword that I never end up getting.
Juan
is backing in the mid lane.
Go. Very bad. Poxassy leading the charge. Larkin, you're about to get McGangbang.
Larkin's
bro.
About to get the
Larkin.
Get
him up. Fuck him up. Kill him. Yes, they give Sejuani first blood.
Sejuani gets first blood, yeah.
Did Larkin heal? Oh, yikes. Yeah, he's double trolling. Oh,
they're taking the tactic frequently up top by Peppa Pigs where they just wait in the bush.
Actually face checks it and gets like I can't say it in words, but
look at this iron.
Yeah, wait,
though.
who placed the ward there?
Larkin did.
Will he be able to see it? Oh, this iron pick may just be. It's not troll. It's big brain.
Dixon going the dark seal this time. He's learned, boys.
Wait, Dixon's going. He knows Stu's there. Not... Poppy's not responding. Oh. Stu might just have to burn the flash here.
Stu was having a hard time taking red?
Yeah, Stu's just gonna...
Oh, no.
Rob's coming in already with his...
Rob's gonna leave the fuzzy cuffs at home for this one. He's just gonna go in.
There's no way!
Stu gets
There's
it!
There's no way!
I don't know what happened.
And the
there.
Mid laner's
somehow
here, too!
Just...
Stu gets a kill on Rob.
He didn't have smite, but Stu missed the smite that... thing went down to like fucking 10 HP.
It was at 1 HP. Wow. Stu somehow coming out on top of there. Congratulations. That just might be the game defying play. Just taking two camps now, might get the Earth 6 and just snowball that
Poppy
advantage.
Is looking
team.
Super low. This Poppy doing damage. We should actually just all in. All in right there, bro.
Larkin and Kelwa looking super low. They're just getting harassed by Aphelios's Calibrum.
Yeah, Aphelios is a cuck to his sister, his moon sister. Cringe. Imagine being the protagonist of Avatar and getting your girlfriend turns into the moon. Still can't get over it.
Oh my goodness.
That's crazy. A lot of trades right there. Force the flash away.
Galio, don't forget the Kyoshi warrior did hit into his tent that night before the big battle.
Dixon, you gotta be very careful. Oh, Dixon! Dixon gets solo killed. It's so greedy.
Dixon is just severely underestimating this pick. Nocturne just can get right on top of anyone with that Q.
He lost his one Dark Seal stack.
Oh,
I cry. TP in the mid lane. This
minion
is not
advantage
like
here.
Oh, he misses the taunt.
Look at this.
Oh no, he's getting fucked up by the minions.
Mid lane coming up, perhaps? Looking at this as an easy
bot
kill.
Lane walking up. Dude, he's baiting the fuck out of Dixon right now.
Dixon is just
going in on me. I got the minion wave. He's literally dangling his little boy.
Oh, shield. Okay. Oh, well,
Well, the dangling of the boy body goes wrong. Top lane looking like some crazy shit going on.
Nocturne coming in.
Oh, no longer an island.
Fear. Oh, there it goes. This
Where
might just be
a Poppy W, bro. You know that Makes you faster, right? Bot lane, looking like a smizzle smazzle.
It looks like it was on cooldown.
The flash. Can he get the kill? No. They get the flash. They get a lot of sums bot. Oh, every sum from Killua and the flash from Puck Sassy.
Well,
both ADCs, no flash or heal, although Larkin will get healed soon.
It's true. GG has started a lot more aggressive.
This game is insane. 5 minutes in, five kills. Kill a minute.
Yeah.
I can't wait till Trade's going in the top lane.
Nothing's gonna come out for him, I don't think.
Poppy beating the fuck out of the cave bear. Wow, that's actually a lot of damage from that. What is that ability, bro? Like, is that the E?
No, that's the auto. The Rame's
auto.
But
the corrupting pot is just gonna keep
pulsing. Oh, it's the passive auto.
Corrupting pot versus corrupting pot.
Yep. I would also like to notify all our viewers that Pogzazi does in fact have 2 vision score.
He might have just doubled his previous score.
No, that's actually 0 vision score. He has 2 wards.
Oh, somebody 2 wards?
He has 2 vision score, 1 ward.
Mid lane looking like a...
fucking... what's his face?
He doesn't want it.
The jump from the Sejuani. Do they dive this? He gets... they gotta leave, bro! This
is not
gonna work for me. Did not need to flash, but like... yeah, no, dude.
And Ivern does stay.
Bro, that's what I love about Ivern.
Interestingly.
It's legit. Quite the cojones. I mean, listen, top lane's got R, mid lane's got R, Stu is a level up.
Top lane did get solo killed, dude.
I mean, Poppy go crazy. Oh, Dixon waiting, pops the ulti, but wait, nothing, there's no other CC. Bruh, that could have been really good.
Yeah, that was... Dixon's just eager to make something happen for himself, and just not working out.
Yeah, he kind of wasted the ult.
Okay.
Oh, Thresh.
I mean, you're kind of wasting everything on the Thresh. This is like a common occurrence that, like, maybe you should start wasting some things on the Sivir.
They hit level 6 out, or am I mistaken?
Well, right now, it seems as though Robert is in the bot lane. He's ready to go Brazy and jump. He's the dragon is up. Hopefully they take it before 15 minutes this game.
It looks like Robert is starting to solo it. Yeah, but Ivern's here.
Ivern knows some fishy shit's up now.
I don't know if they
feels it.
They should. Yep.
Tree
branches.
He didn't even.
Oh, he didn't hit the blue. They gotta help him out. He's gonna die.
They actually take it underneath their noses.
Wow, a lot of damage coming in from Galio. Holy fuck.
Yeah. Galio does a lot of damage.
What's he purchased? His alternator there? He's gonna be doing...
Hextech cuck-alnator, you mean? Oh, he misses the...
Galio is just...
Oh, he's... Galio, you gotta get the fuck out of there. You're baiting your team, bro. This is such an easy double for the spot lane.
Oh my goodness.
Got it?
The ult?
Still coming in.
Honestly, Stu should have ulted onto Julius.
She missed it? No, unfortunate. She didn't get the speed boost off of that.
Yeah.
Spider-Man's way away.
Very tragic.
Mm-hmm. Galio like got the friend, though.
Baited the shit out of his team.
Oh,
and now it seems as though the re-engage is definitely gonna fuck over Zacharias. He might get 2 kills here. Focus the guy gets 2. Why did you walk back in, Stu? You're trolling.
What are you doing, Stu?
Did Stu flash? Wait. Stu flashed on top of him and died. Those
8
clicks going crazy. Definitely going to be a lot of turret plating going to blue side, but like, bro.
It's a massive wave. They might just be able to take it all here. If they get greed. No, they're just backing
up. They don't have a lot of damage. They don't have enough damage for that.
Oh man, this game
Kwan
is...
here, though, is doing quite well up the top.
Oh, he might actually just die right here.
Nah, there's no way he dies.
Peppa Pig.
Got that W up. He can just run away.
It's too scary. Battle of the Titans. Mm-hmm.
Looks like Rob is either going for a gank or this Herald here.
He's been playing Ivern pick. Crazy.
Wow, that Q from Galio does a fucking, like... 1/6 of his
Sejuani
health
blue steel. This is looking quite juicy. Nocturne just taking Krugs in the bot lane. Leave him without mana.
Honestly, I think Krugs is one of the worst camps.
Despite this top lane looking to get converged on by both jungle and Poppy. Interesting.
I mean, that Poppy forces the flash. He's dead here. He's 100% dead here. He has no flash. The ult coming in from the Sejuani takes the kill. I mean, honestly, it doesn't matter who gets the kill in that situation. They're both tanks. They're just beefy front lines for their ADC.
He's just got a few that KD anyway.
Gotta go positive again. Bot lane. Oh no.
Oh no.
Here it comes.
Stu on two. Wow.
God, they actually just giga bursted them.
Stu's big potential on that Nocturne is just
pretty good as well. Yeah, Dixon can't ult.
The lack of vision just completely
Nocturne ult.
Cuckolds him.
Did he just put their portrait?
Nah, I don't think
he he has to be within range or have vision of him. Yeah.
Yep.
And he has no vision of him, so it's. No vision of your own teammates. Quite the odd occurrence, but Nocturne's fear makes it happen.
Okay, Daisy coming out in the mid lane. Nocturne is there, so he's got to be careful with these trades. Daisy, quite an annoyance.
Oh,
the damage going off.
Here's the fear. Yes, dude, just
Thomas
clean it up.
Gotta leave. Get out of there, Thomas. You gotta dash away.
I knew it.
Wow. Misses the flash stun. He doesn't hit the stun. What are you doing? Oh my god. That was super close. He almost didn't hit the blast cone. Top lane getting converged on. I hope they don't try to dive two tanks right here, because that's not looking like a good idea, if I'm gonna be honest, Chief.
They could do it.
If they're right, they've got the little buff.
Got Daisy tanking.
Oh, Daisy's dead.
What's going on here?
I don't know if you can do that, buddy.
Looks like Nocturne getting picked on. He just... Oh, there's the ulti. Yeah, the
TP going down.
Lark is just running away.
Galio deep. Galio so deep.
Ooh. Yeah,
that's the kill here.
Larkin maybe at the
Larkin Q. Might be able to
Larkin flashes.
Flashed onto him.
Yeah, he's dead for that. Flash Larkin.
Larkin expected him not to be dead after that max auto attack. It seems he may have just gotten a lucky crit that just, that lucky crit made him.
I mean, that lucky crit just cost him, about, 700 gold going over to the Aphelios?
I think he intended to flash over and die for anyways, but...
The bonus.
Yeah. Kinda tough.
He didn't get...
The top lane.
What he was looking for out of
there. Oh, he clicks the wrong person.
But psych, that's the wrong number.
Bro, he's tanking because of Bami Cinder.
Oh my god, he's just gonna...
I'm sure if he landed that stun, that was an easy kill. Bot lane, okay, that's kind of
Stu's
troll.
A little...
Stu, that's a very ambitious. I don't know about the flash from Zacharias, but like... That
run was... Ivern, run.
Oh, Ivern, looks like you're gonna get hit right here, buddy.
Oh, there's a lantern.
No, lantern. He's gonna see a flash over the wall.
Oh, nice.
There we go.
I don't know if they go for this dragon.
They're on it. They have the vision.
I mean, Galio does have R. He can always come in. Daisy coming out from the side of
Daisy here to provide
Ivern.
Protection. Oh,
click R.
Juicy
click R.
Lantern.
Here comes Galio.
They kill the Thresh
here. A little
here.
Bit late.
I think Thresh. Yeah.
They continue this. That's a lot of damage coming out onto Pogsassy. They can kill. They can kill both here.
No.
Oh, but they needed to Dixon follow up.
Shield and his. Yeah, there it is. This is cute. Wait, oh, Dixon getting. Come back, Dixon. Elite, man.
I think they die here.
Yeah. Remember,
no,
they don't have
no.
Bot turret, though.
My god, Pogsassy actually gets so many kills!
Oh my goodness, Larkin's just cleaning up.
And
Chilling was that vision score?
Top
two vision score, 92.
Come on, Larkin, do me proud.
Please, God, don't let Larkin put another ward down.
Do me proud, Larkin. One more ward is all I need.
Literally.
Larkin, I'm gonna now go and knock on your door right now. And
you better not do that. That's fucking
cheating.
That, you're raking this. It's not cool, bro.
Another
we have a top lane getting taken here by Cave Bear after a constant siege.
Yep.
Let's see.
They kind of just switched who's gonna carry. It was mid game last, and now it's gonna be bot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Holy fuck, the trade's in the mid lane.
Yeah, Ivern just...
Yeah, but the thing is, Ivern actually... will not do.
The fear coming in? I don't know why he went in there.
His combo lasts, it takes so long for him to get his full combo up because his CDs are so high that true, he doesn't do a lot of damage, but it takes forever for him to, like,
ball lane gonna have a good fight coming soon, maybe. Mid lane and Thresh converging down onto.
How? What? What? What just happened? They jumped into the team. But Larkin's kind of huge.
Oh,
I thought that Aphelios, the Aphelios damage was right. Larkin getting jumped.
No, Aphelios.
What? He gets it.
He's full health too. He just
and then Nautilus
came out
gets
of it.
I think he actually died to the Krugs, not Larkin.
I also think that as well. There's no way that Larkin got the kill there. Maybe he fucking.
I mean, Larkin W'd? Was the last champ to hit him, but the Krugs actually killed him.
I think Larkin's W auto attack might have crit, like it came back onto what's his face.
Meanwhile, there's another blue Robert. For Ivern. He's running to get it now. Just.
That's true. That's kind of OP.
I just really hope to see it disappear in front of this. Watching the run of
I mean, Larkin's pretty fucking huge. He's got the Essence Sweeper.
Larkin is? Slayer. How else?
Tier 2.
Yes, isn't even that high yet. 16 minutes, that's just 100. It's just...
He's disappointing. He's got 8 ward score. Someone
Larkin.
He just, had no. Someone had to have told him.
He must have muted
him
walked to his room.
I'm going to his room. I didn't say anything to him.
Okay. Something going on in the top lane.
Oh
looks like the cave bear got caught out.
Ben coming in with the...
I mean, he gets the 3-man. They're taking a while to kill him. No lie.
He's just limit testing how much damage and abuse he could take.
Okay, I don't know if you win this.
Yeah, you definitely don't win this.
Larkin gonna...
Fucking 1 HP, man.
That's kind of hard.
Larkin just healing up big right here.
Mid lane's looking like a fiesta. What's gonna happen? Who's gonna win? I honestly don't know.
Pushing the bot lane too. Their macro game has certainly improved from before.
They CC'd out the Galio ulti with the Nocturne.
Well, he flashes. Does he still die? I think he does.
No.
Oh, he dies.
And Larkin takes
I don't know who TP'd there. Was that Chogi?
Yeah.
Yeah, oh, sure. That's
the flash coming from the Ivern.
Oh, he gets it.
Good flash eat
the chomp.
My boy is hungry.
They're coming for this red or the blue.
They see him on it though.
But yeah, why don't they fucking kill this dude?
I mean, Ivern's just got to sit here for a little bit.
Yeah.
Oh, the TP. Oh no, he's actually dead here.
No, he's...
Oh, now he's dead.
Larkin's no, Larkin's dead too! Oh, wait.
Oh, the lantern coming just short of...
The knockup!
This
fights, why is everyone fighting for so long? This is just keep on fighting, they don't know
they
when
coming
to
back
stop
for the
fighting.
Blue, of course.
Larkin
gets Kel's here?
Larkin's got IE right now, I'm pretty sure.
What is Kelwa doing right now?
Robert is fighting the jungler. Or Kelwa's fighting Robert.
Yeah.
They're trying to secure the blue buff.
Meanwhile,
Poppy's tanking while TPing. Tanking turret shots, by the way.
Big brain. Sometimes I wonder. Like.
POV.
Some of these players are platinum, correct?
This looks like a mighty fat ADC.
Allegedly, yeah.
Like, just outscale.
Oh my god, the fatty Ivern Q. Gotta be careful. Oh, wow.
Okay. They've just been
Robert falls deep.
Robert had ult
there. Fight
yeah,
after
I think they
fight
been
after fight. It's been
someone.
Insane.
I definitely feel
I don't
like,
think it would be worth for them to jump on just now. I think he should save the ulti and jump for this fight that's going to happen right here.
I think Team GG's team comp is a lot better, to be honest.
Yeah, they get the,
I mean, Infernal. It's hard to kill a team when the team is tank.
Macro certainly just they left been a priority of Larkin, just making sure to take all these turrets.
Health. They get, that goes onto the Ivern. Larkin.
Oh, Larkin just getting focused down by run.
The 2-man flash. Bobby's going balls deep, not gonna get it, but their entire team is gonna die.
Galio just getting slowly chunked here.
Fully willed away.
How many flashes is that? Like 3 in like 2 seconds? Wow.
Oh my god.
Stu flash, Poxassi flash.
They hit Baron.
Flash.
You think the Baron
flashed? Legit. Everyone on Team GG flashed that fight.
I think Larkin and. Yeah, this is slow dragon. I mean, Baron, they could just come back here and catch at the last moment.
Team this... Boss still has a gold lead, but
he'll have his chomp up by that time.
I'm watching Cho. Cho's looking mighty big right now, by the way.
Cho's chomp is up, I hope, by the time he gets
he's
there.
He's not going to get there.
He just snowballs in and eats it.
Snowballs
nah,
in.
Rob smites.
Walking up.
They don't fight this. You guys got to get out of there.
They're greedy. They're greedy. They lose it. They go.
Oh,
yeah, there it is. And
they
stopped another one.
He was like, oh no.
That's a joke.
My god, they just lose their fucking Baron. Why didn't you back there? You know
Poppy and Sejuani still have a Baron on hand.
Yeah, Poppy and Sejuani still have it.
Yeah, but I mean.
Still losing 3 of them right off the bat. It's just quite unfortunate.
They lose 3 and mid tower here.
Yeah.
Larkin is 16 and 3, bro. He's kind of bravey.
Larkin's just doing well because he had a good team behind him, you know?
Yeah. Larkin has a 700 gold bounty right now, by the way.
Okay, well, Baron Buff's still on 2 players. Alright. Oh, he's going Super Balls, Deep Aronian, Cheddar Cheese. They get the Ivern, though. He's forced to flash. Nocturnal going off. Everybody's can't see anything.
Oh
look
my
at
god,
the damage.
It's just flawless execution side of Larkin.
Wasn't even there. Wow. They actually end the game off this, by the way.
Is this the FF22? Like, what's happening here?
2
perhaps
players.
A rotation top to take the other turret. Oh.
They end the fucking game. This is crazy. How many points?
Oh, we're gonna see a Shelly dance.
We are. Legit 9 seconds for jungle and ADC to get back up, but it's too late. It's too late. Shelly's about to hit the Nexus. There you go. Wow, this
is that's the game. And here comes a dancing lobster.
Shelly's dancing.
Wow, very anticlimactic.
Such dominant games. Wow. 20 minutes and 22 minutes coming in back to back. Just
Larkin damage went crazy. Sivir auto burr.
Larkin's damage coming out head and shoulders above everybody, doubling the next closest, which is the Galio. Just
Galio doing second most damage, by the way.
And
champion
only having
busted.
He's had second most damage and had half the damage still. Larkin.
1 second, folks. We'll be
muted
back very soon. Give a second. We have breaking news from the other series. Apparently, what's it called? Permanent Team 3 won a game off an AD Sion backdoor base raid.
Oh, can we actually see that? Are they still playing?
I have no clue, but we will be back with you soon.
No way.
And we are back, folks. Adrian, would you like to do the honors?
I'd like to congratulate Larkin for the MVP of this.
Absolutely ridiculous.
Larkin, how do you feel about that Vision Score game one?
Yeah, I mean, look, all I can say is I'm kind of the macro head of the team. I don't know, Kellowa doesn't really contribute to the vision, so
I had to do it myself. You know? For game two, wait, I know you had insider information. There's no way you would have placed eight.
Breaking
goals.
News, Larkin broke double digits.
Oh boy.
It's a new one from, I've certainly never seen one before.
I mean, it's quite easier than applause.
Yep. I believe, I've never seen an ADC with double digits on their vision
you
score.
You brought out the Jinx, I know. And I love you for it, because I was
the with Jinx.
Jinx this entire series.
I played two games of Jinx this afternoon, and it just felt so overpowered. I'm pretty sure it's Sleeper OP.
Oh my goodness.
The champion is insane.
Thank you so much. You just gave me so many credits right now in this. Gamer coins, it's just raining.
That is true.
Yeah,
another step closer towards the body pillow. I'm actually commemorating you for this.
God damn it. Yeah, I don't
ideally,
know.
Ideally, I get Alex's used one if I win. But
so the Ivern mid, why? Well, what was the thought process?
Let's just say until they start banning it, they're gonna keep losing against it. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. Honestly, it's honestly super OP for the rest of the team. Like Stu, when she goes in, it's really hard for her to die because she just has a fat shield.
Yeah, but
on
he
top
built
of
damage. It's not like he built
Well, of course,
enchanter.
I mean,
you
know, it's not like he built support. You know what I mean?
Well, I mean, come on. I mean, we gotta take a make it a little
if you're
flexible.
Playing
you know?
For the utility, why not build on top of the shields already? It's like just such a big part of the kit.
Dude, I mean, I bet that Leandre's is doing work, dude. I don't know the four tank comp. I mean, I don't know. We saw four tanks.
Yeah, but why did you
Larkin?
You didn't think he was good?
We just wanted to play something different because honestly, we played like seven games of Vayne or something.
Care to speak about the early game against the Aphelios? He seemed to have a
we're kind of running it in lane. Oh my god, especially after the first blood. Oh boy, I don't know. We should have done
like
that.
Honestly, face tanked it, dude.
I don't know. I blew heal for no reason.
Flashes into fucking Dixon just to die.
Okay, that was bad too. Crit. Look, I was literally just gonna say you guys picked my worst series to give MVP.
You, yeah.
I mean, you kind of don't do anything like other series, so it's kind of throw your bone here.
And especially, that was before the restart or the reshuffle of teams.
But anyway, I don't know. We all just played really well. I think.
It was
really just kind of.
By everyone.
I don't know. Yeah, we just got advantages in lane. We closed really fast with the Herald. So
kind of a fiesta in those team fights. It was very hard to keep track of what
was
going
on. Yeah, we almost threw the game. I mean, we almost gave him Baron. It was pretty bad.
It was just team fight after team fight after team fight. It just seemed like it was a nonstop fight to like keep that.
It's true.
Yeah, I don't know.
I mean, you did give them Baron, but like then they gave it right back. You know what I mean?
Yeah, exactly. I don't know what to say about this one. This was such a fast game. It was like,
especially that first game, finishing just at 20 minutes.
That might be a record for our.
First
game was like 1958, and the second game was like 22. Kind
of crazy. Yeah, these are very fast games out of the teams tonight.
Yeah, I don't know what to think. I mean,
just because it was fast doesn't mean it wasn't a strong finish though in each game. It was
in both teams. Like...
True. I am proud that we were able to like close it out really fast. We got the Heralds and then we were able to close out with both Heralds, so it was good. But other than that, it's not much to take
I will
away
say
from
about
it.
Both games, I thought it was losable the whole time. So
I was scared. Yeah, I saw the pick bans for the first game, and I was like, "Damn, Larkin's just gonna
peel over
and
Larkin
get blown
just...
up."
Yeah, I was afraid for my points. Those odds seemed like kind of juicy on the other side, but then
we let them know. You don't know.
Well, thanks for coming. You guys all played well.
Everyone gets to go to bed early tonight.
This is true.
There is another game going on simultaneously. However, the production has decided. I believe they're on game three too. But I think the production has decided that we
don't
will not
watch
be
it?
Doing it today.
Yeah.
No, unfortunately not.
We'll be watching the reruns.
They're on game three.
I think they might be on game two.
How did they play games faster than Larkin?
Oh yeah. They might. Okay, I must be wrong. Yeah. They must be on. No, we started this series around 9:30 as well. Oh, no, 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 yeah, that must be game two. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, because they also started their series at 9:30. So okay. Right now it's, what, one up for team...
Permanent team three, I think?
For permanent team three?
I believe so. Okay.
Very interesting. We will...
Nice.
We will tell you the results of the game.
Not on stream.
No, no, definitely not, but like...
I mean, it'll come out, eventually.
The bottle.
Hell yeah.
Well,
all
right.
GG's, guys.
Wait, we have to do the final summary stuff. So, would you like to say anything to your friends or family back home?
I don't know. Just team played well.
Teammates, maybe? Teammates?
I'm proud of the team. Very clean game, honestly. A bit of a motivation booster, especially because it was the first time we'd played with Derek. So, you know, felt good. Yeah.
Cool. Next week, you will be playing Permanent Team 3. How do you feel going into that series?
After this series, feeling pretty confident.
All right.
Mm-hmm. I would say.
Thank you, Larkin, for the interview.
Can I say something to Larkin's family?
No, leave Larkin, leave.
Yeah.
All right.
Larkin, since you
came off of a couple of devastating
your family losses. Gets spared.
All right, so thank you, guys. That's going to be it from us, folks. Would you like to have any finishing comments, casters?
Not really. Those games were a banger, and about it.
Quick series, but it was interesting nonetheless.
It kept your attention for sure. All that action happening just constantly, each minute filled with like at least something happening, kills going down,
first blood being taken. Game to watch.
Apologies again for not streaming the other game. Unfortunately, due to just scheduling issues, it wasn't possible. But we do have our next game on Sunday, which will be Blue Corn Tortilla Chips versus Monkeys Strong Together.
Yeah, Blue Corn Tortilla is coming in quite strong in the series.
Your own team a pat on the back here.
Hey! I was about to compare with Peppa Pigs, who just at this point we seem to be the two like most, you know, consistent competitors.
Sounds like you're patting yourself on the back here.
No, I'm patting Peppa's on the back too, though. It's like simultaneous. It's just. You ever seen Silicon Valley where
this
it's
is no,
just
no 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 no, 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 no
right.
Thank you for coming to the stream, folks. We will catch you later on Sunday.